Somebody asked me, good question, who created God? Why are you talking of God? Somebody must have created God also. I said, sure. There are several gods, several layers being created. Eventually, what do you go back to? If you really woke up again and again and went to the absolute source, which created God, what would you call it? What power would that be? And I said, there is no word for that, and therefore, for lack of any word, we call it the Word. In the beginning was the Word. The Word was with God, and the Word was God. You read that in John's Gospel, opening verse. In the Hindu Vedas, Rig Veda opens with the sentence, in the beginning was the Nad, the sound. The Nad was the creator. All things were made by that. Exact translation of John's Gospel. Written 1,000 years apart, these two things have been written. So if you go back, what's the origin, what created God, is the power which can be translated into modern English as totality of consciousness. I think that's the most appropriate word I could find. A totality of consciousness in which nothing exists outside of it. It is consciousness which creates all forms, creates all beings, creates all souls, creates all experiences, creates all regions. It's that totality of consciousness that comes down and cannot be disconnected from any part of creation is right here with us. As human beings, we have a source to that totality of consciousness inside. That's where consciousness operates, in the body. In the human body, when you say, I am a conscious being, where are you saying it from? You are saying it from your head, in the wakeful state. Where do you say it from? In the dream state, when you're sleeping and having a dream, you say, I am consciousness. You say it from what looks like the head in the dream is actually the throat of the physical body, and so on. That notional position shifts. But in the wakeful state in which we are sitting now, it's right behind the eyes, operating in the head, the seat of consciousness. And what is linked inside the seat of consciousness? The complete route to totality of consciousness. So when we say spiritual path is to withdrawing your consciousness to its very roots and go back to totality of consciousness. Even God is created by that totality of consciousness. And that consciousness we call Word, Shabd, Nad, same names. Kalma. You can call it by any language, any religion, same words are there. And then we say these are audible. We can hear them. God can't be heard. Or can we? Maybe we do. But what these are names, word. Word means something that can be spoken, can be heard. Nad, music can be heard. Music of the spheres, the Greeks talked of, can be heard. Songs can be heard, music can be heard, all sounds can be heard. Then it's audible. That means, is it fair to say that the ultimate creator is merely audible sound current? Well, it's a good expression also. We can use it. It's not literal. It cannot be literally true, because these are... So what is the effect of this? A great impact of this definition is that if it can be heard, why not hear it? Listen to it. If it is part of consciousness and not part of the sounds outside, it should not be heard by the eardrums, but should be heard somewhere else. The eardrums are not designed to hear sounds inside. They're designed to hear sound from outside, transmit through the connections with the brain and make us feel that we are hearing something from outside. They don't hear inside, but supposing there's a sound inside, we have to hear it from some other ears. The ears of consciousness can hear the sound of consciousness inside. So when we meditate and we draw our attention, the power of hearing, power of listening comes into play. And that is what takes us to the root of consciousness, to the source of consciousness, listening.